Thank you. Blood.
Please help me!
Help! Sir! Sir, unchain me, please. A woman?
You make a lot of noise. Are you trying to alert the Diamanos to your exact location?
The Diamanos?
A tribe of cannibals. This is their land. This is where they feast.
Please. I don't know why I've been imprisoned here.
You must be of the criminal class.
Why do you spurn me with curses, madam? I bear you no ill will.
I said it because the only people that they could chain to these trees are the town miscreants. The criminals, they feed them to the cannibals.
Never heard of such a thing.
It's cheaper than public hanging, and it also keeps the cannibals at bay. Keeps them from entering the town proper and eating everyone else.
It appears I chose the wrong town to newly inhabit.
Who are you? Your name?
I am Kel'jin. Thief and tracker for hire. I'm innocent, of course. Now please, if you don't mind.
Hurry and unchain me!
Shh!
If you could find a large rock or something, I believe I could break the... You have a key, madam!
I had it on me when I committed my crime.
You speak as if you planned your death.
Not death. My capture.
I don't understand.
It's not important that you do.
My lady, I am in your debt.
You're free. Leave this place and never return. It's crawling with man-eaters.
Upon declaration of this, may I propose we leave together?
I am staying. I have a, purpose.
Right. And that purpose should be finding an immediate way out of this forest.
Nay. Sadly, I must travel deeper into the cannibals' territory.
You are out of your mind, woman.
Depart from me. Please.
You don't even know the girl. Damn it, Kel'jin.
Cursed place. Are you injured?
No, I'm fine. Thanks to you. And you?
Thanks to you, I'll live. I may never be able to sleep again after the sight of that ravenous madman, but I'll survive. We should stick together. We'll be stronger that way.
I thought you said I was out of my mind.
Allow me to offer you a proper introduction. I'm Kel'jin, son of Greg.
I am Bridget.
Now that we've survived death together, maybe you wouldn't mind telling me how you ended up here in this forest. With a key.
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
I am a bit of a skeptic, but you freed me. And I do love a good story.
I needed to get into the Forbidden Forest, as only the condemned are brought here. Being arrested and sentenced to death was my only way in.
But why?
You're too inquisitive for a thief, don't you think?
I'm a thief. And a tracker. And trackers, as you may well know, are very inquisitive
by trade.
So please, do tell.
I seek a necromancer who inhabits these lands.
A necromancer? Is it in league with these cannibals?
Of course not. I seek Velkara. That's my true purpose of being here.
Velkara?
Isn't that supposed to be a uni?
A legend? A myth? Only believed by the fools?
Most unicorns are, yes.
She exists. Velkara the unicorn is real. I know it.
You're speaking of a fabled unicorn. A tall tale at best.
Cursed by the vile tongue of a thief. Velkara walks among us. And these woods, before being plundered by the Diamantis tribe, were her sacred home. And I might be a foolish dreamer, but I will find her.
Calm thyself, woman. I propose this. Since you save me from being eaten, I will, after immediately escorting you out of this forest, steal you the prettiest horse in all the land. My gift to you.
If only it were that easy.
It would be easier than it was for you to steal that key. I don't know of any thief, myself included, who would dare steal from the royal guard.
I didn't steal them. My husband had many friends in the king's old guard. One of them gave me this key. He had no idea why I needed it, but still. The difficult part for me was trying to get arrested and sentenced to death so I could be sent here.
Really? I found that part to be remarkably easy.
He almost smiled.
Well, on that note,
we shall leave here immediately.
And allow me to bring you the most dashing horse in all the land. It won't have a horn on its head, but that's a minor detail of little importance. Certainly not worth your life.
I appreciate your offer, but I need the real unicorn. And I know she's near. I close my eyes. And I can feel her so clearly. In her presence, I will find joy once again. The Diamantis are afoot. And hungry, I'd wager.
Situation unknown is a direful situation at best. It is not a wise idea. And she's gone.
This is too dangerous.
Don't be a fool.
No one deserves to die like that.
A murderer by the looks of him.
You don't know that. Unhand me.
You're out of your mind.
Must be. I helped you, didn't I?
Well, what are you going to do?
Free him.
I'm not trekking these forests with that brute by my side. I mean, look at the size of him!
Bravery, thief. It's a virtue. Now, help me if you would. Distract the cannibal, and I'll sneak in.
I can't! I do not wish to perish in an attempt to release a dangerous criminal! That's madness!
So be it.
Wait, where are you going?
I have a key. I will get you out of here. It should work.
Thank you.
How much more of this misery do you wish to endure?
As much as it takes.
All for a mythical unicorn.
Perhaps.
But why, damn it? You owe me that at least.
It is said that the unicorn can grant wishes to anyone who can find her.
Yeah, well, I have lots of wishes. None that I'd risk my life for.
Well, I only have one, and I would risk everything.
Can't be.
What is it?
Unusual hoof prints in the ground.
Velcro.
I said unusual. I didn't say anything about a wish-granting unicorn. My lord, do you realize how preposterous that sounds?
Follow the tracks. Please. You said you were a tracker.
This way. Helping these tracks lead us out of this cursed land.
If they do, I'll bid you a safe farewell. However, I have a feeling this might be Velcro herself.
Single-minded. That's for certain.
Look, snow. We're close.
To the unicorn. How?
I've been dreaming of her, and in all of my dreams, there's snow.
Even better. Now we can be crazy and cold.
Look, we're being followed.
Is that the brute?
It appears so. What if he's the...
A lunatic. Most likely. Come on, we must hurry.
Or maybe he's an untrustworthy thief like yourself.
Hardly. He's probably waiting until we weaken, so that way he can slaughter us where we slumber.
Why are you following us? We're cursed, don't you know?
Bloody ape. Let's continue on. What are you doing?
He's mimicking our steps. Warrior, as my friend here asked, why are you following us?
You're my last chance.
What?
His last chance.
What does that mean? I don't understand.
I don't like the sound of that.
He's like...
Nor the look of him.
Weird.
Come. We must keep away.
I don't know. Let's see what happens if we stop for respite.
Agreed, but don't look back. we just observe. Now I'll just pretend to yawn and...
Is he still there?
Not only is he still there, but he's staring directly at us.
Is he walking too, or is he staring?
No, he's just... No, don't you do it too. He's not going to believe 2 yawns in a row.
I yawn when I see someone else yawn. This is very believable.
Wonderful. Now he's seen your heaven bosoms, will probably want to ravish you even more.
Think that's what he wants?
I mean, he looks the sort. That's probably why they put him in chains in the first place.
Right, run! I don't see him behind us anymore.
Thank goodness. Why did he start chasing us?
They chained him to a tree to be executed. What else did you expect from someone like him?
I found you the same way.
True. But I'm just a harmless thief.
How do I know? Perhaps you said thief to make yourself sound harmless.
Very well. I'll prove my expertise to be exactly what I proclaimed when we first met.
That's mine! That was in my vest!
I just didn't want you thinking I was lying about me being a thief.
That was my daughter's necklace. My beautiful lily.
Apologies are in the good king's order. Please accept my humble regret as sufficient justice.
This is all I have left of her. I lost my husband to the Crusades, and my daughter to the plague. You see, my friend, I have nothing to go home to. Nothing but a few pots, some old tools, and a blanket. I used to cover my husband and daughter with at night. Those possessions are just cruel reminders now. And I can't stand the thought of returning to my home and covering myself with the same blanket. What was once warm has grown cold. This quest for Velkara, this silly fantasy of a unicorn, it's all I have left.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Keldon, that you had to die like this. May you find peace in the afterlife, and your heart be filled with all the treasures it desired here on this wretched earth. It's you. I freed you, and yet you follow me.
You're my last chance.
Yes, I remember you said that before. I didn't know what you meant then, and I still don't. Well, this has been very enlightening, but I have to go. I have an appointment to keep, if you'll excuse me. I bid you good day. Oh, you're still following me. How nice. Warrior?
My name is Viren.
Viren. That's a beautiful name. You saved me.
You were my last chance at being selfless. I've never been selfless. Only selfish. That's why I ended up chained against a tree. Condemned. You risked your life to free me. And you're selfless. I'm sure. I want to be there.
You gave your life for me, Viren. You're a true hero. Thank you.